wood stove at the Beaver.
Well, at the end of your program, you say it's for sale.
You what? Oh, say it's for sale? I will.
Yeah.
I will. I saw the signs out there. Let me guess, you want to sell the place and retire to Arizona or Boise?
I want to sell the place and
just
leave the headaches.
Yeah. How long you been doing it? Running the Beaver.
Years.
Jeez. If you do anything that long, it gets old.
Oh yeah.
Hell, if I deer hunted it full time, that would get old. Yeah, I gotta get one once in a while. I do a lot of shooting, but not so much hitting. What would a place like this cost, Russ?
Well, with all of the rooms out here, and
yeah,
the house out back, and with all the new improvements, I'm gonna have to have liquor license and everything. It's gonna be $700,000.
Oh, okay. I was going to say like a million, million and a half. Wow.
That would work, huh?
Yeah.
I'd take that.
You take that.
Living on the road, my friend, was gonna keep you free and clean. And now you wear your skin like iron, and your breath is hard as kerosene. You weren't your mama's only boy, but her favorite one, it seemed. She began to cry when you said goodbye. Your dream. Pancho was a bandit boy. His horse was fast as polished steel. He wore his gun outside his pants for all the honest world to feel. Well, Pancho met his match, you know, on the deserts down in Mexico. Nobody heard his dying word. Oh, but that's the way it goes. All the Federalists say they could have had him any day. They only let him slip away out of kindness, I suppose. Lefty, he can't sing the blues all night long like he used to. But Dusty Poncho, bit down south, ended up in Lefty's mouth. The day they laid poor Poncho low, Lefty split for Ohio, where he got the bread to go. is living in a cheap hotel. The desert's quiet, Cleveland's cold. And so the story ends, we're told. Pancho need your prayers, it's true. We'll save a few for Lefty too. He only did what he had to do. And now he's grown up. Let him.